more than I paid for it. Okay, it's all yours. Driving around with her father in an old car and trailer. They just left.
Which way'd they go?
Going north.
Thanks. So am I.
So I started to keep an eye out for a car with a trailer. And a few miles up the road, there they were. Obviously in some kind of trouble. I stopped. But of course I would have stopped anyway. Because there was the same gal up on a nearby hillside.
Hello, young fella. Want to buy a painting?
No, thanks.
Game of cribbage?
No.
A lot of people play cribbage, end up buying a painting. Whole back end's full of them. Know anything about engines?
Some. What seems to be the trouble?
Well, have a look. If it isn't one thing, it's another. Engines, brakes. Here, I'll show you. Doggone battery.
Better let me give you a push.
Hope you would. Just wanted to say thank you.
Not at all. But I'd do something about that car of yours if I were you. I don't think it's safe.
She's all we have. Have to make her last.
Well. Hey, look! It's moving! I felt so sorry for any two people in my life. Her name was Connie. Her father was retired on a little pension, and she managed to sell enough paintings to just keep going. And then the whole thing went up in smoke. What did you do? Well, I had a car. Wasn't going anywhere. What could I do? So I hooked my station wagon to their trailer, and we drove off together. And frankly, I wasn't at all sorry to do it. My vacation was turning out a lot better than I'd expected. What Connie felt, she kept to herself. And her dad? Well, it was hard to tell what he thought, too. We headed for Interlochen, pulled into a pretty grove of pines and made us comfortable. Then I heard music. Hundreds of youngsters come to Interlochen every summer, come from all over the country to play, sing, dance, and study. It's a wonderful spot.